driving a tractor on roads and highways can be done safely, if it's done correctly. Hi, I'm Matt with State Fund. In this video, we're going to cover safety essentials for hitting the highway with your tractor. Inspect your tractor each day prior to operation for proper functioning of tires, horn, lights, battery, controller, brakes, steering mechanism, cooling system, and so on. Now, before you get your tractor on the road, you must get it road ready. The higher speeds necessary for driving on streets, roads, and highways require setting up the tractor differently than for the field. First off, make sure the slow moving vehicle or SMV sign is clean and visible if you'll be driving slowly on public roads. If you'll be traveling over 25 miles per hour, be sure to remove your SMV sign. If necessary, adjust the toe-in setting on the front axle. Check the manufacturer's manual for details. Next, balance your tractor with ballast depending on the load you'll be carrying or pulling. This should improve your stability and handling on the road. Lock the steering brakes together. If not, your tractor could pull hard to the left or right in an emergency stop, which could easily cause you to lose control. Disengage differential locks. And if your tractor is a four-wheel drive model, switch over to two-wheel drive. Side note, you may not carry additional riders on your tractor unless you have the appropriate seating in place. Tractor-mounted personnel transport carriers, PTCs, aren't allowed on the roads. Next, plan your route. Know exactly which road you'll be using before you depart. Just before you head out, test one time that the steering brakes make straight stops. And if you're driving a rollover protected machine, be sure to buckle up. This simple procedure has saved many lives. Your seatbelt should be tightened enough so that your body is confined within the ROPS protected area. When entering a roadway, stop and look both ways. Wait for traffic to clear before turning out. Turn on your flashers and running lights. The more visible you are to other drivers, the safer you'll be. Keep your tractor in your lane and not halfway on the shoulder. Keep to the right of your lane and drive at a steady pace. If a group of cars forms behind you, find a safe place to pull off and let them pass. Don't motion or wait for traffic to go around you. Hand signals can be misunderstood and you can end up causing an accident. Approach intersections slowly and clearly signal what you intend to do well in advance. Reduce your speed when turning and anytime you encounter a blind spot. Make it your goal to operate your tractor smoothly. Avoid jerking turns, starts, or stops. Always keep your tractor's transmission in gear. Never coast with the clutch in or the shift lever in neutral. This places too much of the work of slowing the machine on the brake system and can easily lead to losing control. For nighttime driving, visibility is key. Use all of the safety practices we just covered, plus a few more. If possible, have an escort vehicle with the appropriate signs and lights accompany you. If an escort isn't available, then make your tractor visible to other traffic by using your headlights and taillights. Flashing amber lights aren't required, but can make you more visible, especially on a dark and rainy highway. If your tractor is equipped with turn signals, be sure to use them when signaling turns. Now let's talk about towing equipment with your tractor. To tow safely, be sure to hitch to the draw bar only. Never hitch to an axle or other part of your tractor. Incorrect hitching can result in a rear axle turnover. Always use a safety chain. It can keep a hitch that comes loose from turning into a disaster. Make sure the chain you use has a positive locking device to prevent from coming loose and that it is strong enough to support your load. Check locks, pins, and other attachment devices. Lock the draw bar to the center position if you'll be traveling at higher speeds. Make sure that you set the equipment up in the proper transport position. Keeping implements low to the ground gives good driving stability and keeps your vision from being impaired. But be sure to keep them high enough so you don't scrape on the pavement when the road gets bumpy. Check the manufacturer's manual for details if you have questions about how to set up your equipment for road transport. If your equipment requires a three-point hitch, then follow the manufacturer's directions. Lift carriers or implement carriers must be driven slowly to maintain control. Measure the length and width of the PTO you'll be towing and know the rules and regulations for permits, flagging, and lights regarding extra long or wide loads. The maximum speed for lift carriers is 35 miles per hour. Watch for side-to-side swaying of the equipment being transported. If possible, have a warning or escort vehicle travel with you. Also, make sure the PTO has an appropriate guard in place. If not, don't use the tractor. When towing liquids, start and stop extra slowly. The liquid sloshing front to back when starting or stopping can destabilize your trailer, causing loss of control. Likewise, make slow turns to avoid side-to-side slosh that can tip a trailer over. Carry an appropriate fire extinguisher if you'll be transporting flammable materials. Of course, none of these safety measures will prevent an accident if you choose not to use them. Incorporate these practices into your work routine, and you'll be doing your part to help keep our highways and roads safe. For more information, visit www.safeatworkca.com, where you'll find lots of resources to help keep your workplace as safe as possible. For all of us at State Fund, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.